saint of the day is Blessed Mother Mary Poussepain. Born in 1653, she is remembered today as the foundress of the Dominican Sisters of Charity of the Presentation, an institute which only within the past century has begun to be recognized as part of the regular Dominican sisterhood. Mary was born in the Diocese of Versailles in 1653. Her well-to-do family had a reputation for both sanctity and sound business. She might have entered religion earlier, but the illness of her mother required her constant care. When Mary was 22, her mother died, and the girl took over the management of the house. It soon became apparent that her plans for contemplative life would have to be revised, for her father fell ill, and she was needed to care for him. Since her home was situated conveniently between the Hospital of the Sisters of Charity and the church, where the Dominican Third Order regularly met, Mary soon found herself involved in the charities of the one and the spiritual life of the other. She became a tertiary, and she placed herself under the guidance of a Dominican confessor, who was to watch over her for nearly half a century. She began to dream of a Dominican community in which these works would become part of the apostolate. The bishop with whom most of her negotiations had to be made was a man who heartily disliked the Dominicans. Mary began her Institute of the Dominican Sisters of Charity in Angerville, and the sisters wore the colors of the order, quite probably because they were not permitted the same form of religious habit as was worn by the regular communities of the Dominicans. They had a Dominican director, and everyone agrees the Dominican spirit. But when it came to obtaining affiliation with the order, they were blocked by the bishop's refusal, and probably in view of this, by the reluctance of the order to force their claims. At the age of 90, as she lay on her deathbed, her order had spread all over France and was recognized as a religious institute, but never accepted into the Dominican family, was not even able to recognize the Feast of Saint Dominic as a solemnity without losing their status. Accepting the will of God, she commanded her sisters to remain spiritually close to the great order that she loved, and she died with no assurance that they would ever realize her desire. 50 years later, the French Revolution broke out. A few years later after that, more Dominican privileges were granted, and the sisters pressed the question of affiliation. But it was not until 1897, two full centuries after the foundress first began her project, was her community allowed to use the full title, Dominican Sisters of Charity of the Presentation of the Most Blessed Virgin Mary. She died in 1744 and beatified by John Paul II. Blessed Mother Mary Poussepain, pray for us.
Praise be to God in all things. The gospel today comes to us from Luke chapter 12, verses 1 through 7. At that time, so many people were crowding together that they were trampling one another underfoot. Jesus began to speak first to his disciples. Beware of the leaven, that is, the hypocrisy of the Pharisees. There is nothing concealed that will not be revealed, no secret that will not be known. Therefore, whatever you have said in the darkness will be heard in the light, and what you have whispered behind closed doors will be proclaimed on the housetops. I tell you, my friends, do not be afraid of those who kill the body, but after that can do no more. I shall show you whom to fear. Be afraid of the one who, after killing, has the power to cast into Gehenna. Yes, I tell you, be afraid of that one. Are not 5 sparrows sold for two small coins? Yet not one of them has escaped the notice of God. Even the hairs of your head have all been counted. Do not be afraid. You are worth more than many sparrows. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Adrian, anything from Cornelius today?
Yes, absolutely. Cornelius Lapide commenting on the passage, there is nothing hid which shall not be unhid, nothing covered which shall not be uncovered. He says, the meaning is, although the Jews slander you as being not of God, but the apostles and ambassadors of Beelzebub, yet fear ye not their derision or contempt, for God in the end will make plain your innocence and true religion, not only in the day of judgment, but even in this life. He goes on and said, it can also be explained thus, do not fear or shrink, O my apostles, from preaching my gospel. For although but few may believe in the beginning, that it may appear hidden and concealed, yet it shall creep on by degrees, and its truth shall at length be known and shall shine forth through the world. Now, there's much to be said here on this whole passage, but since I only have about 40 more seconds, I will conclude with this thought. Cornelius Alapide here is trying to emphasize the point that we may lose human respect. We may be derided. We may be cursed. I hear this all the time. Protestants saying, you're worshiping idols. You're worshiping demons. This Our Lady of Fatima, that was a demonic apparition. Things like that. They accuse us of being ambassadors of Beelzebub. These things have not changed since the time of the apostles. So let us be steel ourselves. Let us bear ourselves with Christ. So that way we may recognize that when people come after us, what is true will be made manifest to all one day. So do not fear derision. Instead, stand by Christ, even in the face, and have moral courage.
Amen. Praise be to God. You know, do not fear the one who can kill the body reminded me that it's been a pretty violent week in America. How much do we trust in God? I want to talk to you about that, violence in America, and Our Lady of Fatima, all that coming up right after this very quick break. Don't go anywhere. Catholic Drive Time. Be right back.